I want to tell you today, there's no turning back. Mark was singing that song, there's no turning back. There is no turning back. Because where God is bringing the church, and I cannot shake this from my spirit, this year, where God is bringing the church, I'm telling you, it's time for total takeover. It's time, listen to, it's time for total annihilation of the devil. Where he has been trying to contest you, where he has been trying to mess with you, where he has been trying to thwart and hinder what God desires to do, I'm telling you, church, it's time to take him down. It's time for a fresh anointing to come upon the body of Christ that will not merely refresh us, but will empower us as Jesus was commissioned to destroy all the works of the devil. That same anointing God is putting upon us. And there's something of a rising up I feel happening in the church, in the body of Christ. There's a rising up. And there's a purpose for this anointing. There's a purpose for it. There's a new breed. Hallelujah. I said it the other night. There's a new breed that God is raising up, that God is anointing. And it's not just an age group. Although young people will certainly be a significant part. But it's a spiritual group that God is raising up. And David rises up in the Holy Spirit. And then Saul tries to put his armor on him. And this is what I want to say. Saul represents the old order. Saul represents that which was before. Saul represents the way it was. He represents an old wineskin. He represents an old method. He can even represent an old move of God. A method, a way of doing things. You see, because when David was going to go out to battle, there was a way to go out to battle. And Saul said, "You need armor, David, so here, take my armor." And you see, what happens is the old thing always tries to put its method on the new thing. The old way always tries to impose itself over on something new and fresh that God is wanting to do. So here Saul, well-meaning probably, said, "David, what you need is my armor. What you need, David, to fight this battle, what you need, David, if you're going to fight against this giant, you need, because you certainly won't be able to do it unless you have my armor on you, unless you use my method, unless you know how I've done it." So Saul tried to put his armor onto David, and David kind of clunked around in it a little bit. And he said, "I can't fight in this. I haven't tested it." You see, David was wise. Even though it seemed maybe outwardly would give him a little bit more protection, a little more safety. You know, it's safe. You know, we've done it this way before. You know, this way worked before. You know, it's safe in this place. You know, let's why rock the boat? Why make waves? Why try to do something that hasn't been done before? Let's just do it the same way.
Wow. That's good.
But David said, "I haven't tested this."
Wow. That's right. Amen.
And this is what I want to say to you. Every little battle you face in your day-to-day life is merely a preparation and a testing for you to go higher, to eventually not only slay the lion and the bear, but to eventually take down Goliath. Every little battle you face, every time you wrestle a bear, every time you wrestle a lion, every time the Lord allows that testing in your life, every time God allows that conflict, that confrontation in the spirit to take place in your life, God is merely preparing you. God is merely letting you test out your weapons of war so that when the day of destiny comes for you to stand to take down that which opposes the kingdom of God, you will be ready to annihilate the works of the devil. And David said, "I can't do it the way you've done it. I can't wear the armor you've worn. I have not walked in this. I have not tested this." And there was a new anointing that came on David. He was anointed by the Spirit of God. And years ago, The Holy Spirit spoke to me when He very, very first called me to ministry. And I understand the prophetic word today when God said to me, Matt, you cannot carbon copy yourself after anything you see with your natural eyes. There will be no model that you can follow. There will be no model that you can copy, because what I will do in the days ahead will be so new and different that you will have to hear my voice to know Amen. Which direction to move in.
Amen.
And I feel even with past moves of the Spirit, thank God for everything that's done in history, but God forbid that we would ever copy or model ourselves after something we have already seen, after something that we've seen work in the past, because the anointing that we need today is different than the anointing of yesterday. What God wants to do today is different than what He did yesterday. And even as Pastor was sharing this morning, that the anointing of last year is not enough for what God wants to do this year. Even the way you did things last year is not enough for what God wants to do this year. Because where God is transitioning you into, where God is bringing you into, it is a new thing. It is a new thing. And there may be times where things are different. But that's when you have to step out of the comfort zone. You have to step out of that which you knew to work yesterday in order to take up that which has been tested and tried in your life. Never despise the little day-to-day battles, because those are just opportunities for you to train your hands for war. And David says to the Philistine, you come to me with a sword, with a spear, with a javelin. You come to me with the weapons of flesh. You come to me with the weapons of man. But I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. David says, you haven't defied me, you have defied God.
Amen.
And I'm not coming against you with weapons of the flesh. I'm coming against you in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And this day, he declares, this day the Lord will deliver you into my hand. And I will strike you and take your head from you. And this day I will give the carcasses of the camp of the Philistines to the birds of the air and the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. And this is the key, verse 47. Then all this assembly shall know that the Lord does not save with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and He will give you into our hands.
Amen.
And David runs toward the Philistine. Charges him. Takes his slingshot, bam, the first shot, slays him dead. Doesn't have a sword, had no weapons, so runs over and takes Goliath's own sword, takes the weapon of the enemy and uses it against him and cuts his head off.